Happy Friday, Fort Mill. I'm Stephanie.
And I'm Chad. We hope you had a great week this week.
This week's show is Thanksgiving themed because it's our last show until Thanksgiving break.
Coming up this week, Alexis shows us how we can help those in need, Bada got a chance to meet some turkeys, and Abby found out everything we're grateful for this season. All that and more right after this.
Fun having a Thanksgiving meal with all of our Buzz family.
It really was. Thank you, Ayana and Hunter, for using the hashtag TheBuzz from FMHS. That makes you our fans of the week.
We're going to get to know a little more about Ayana and Hunter as they take on 7 Seconds.
Hey, my name's Ayana, aka Queen A, aka Yay Yay. I'm single, I like to eat and sleep, and Yakima to the death of me.
I'm Hunter, I'm 14, I'm a freshman, I'm from New Jersey. I like sports, I like music, and go Yankees.
My name is Liz Dukes. I teach dance. I have a daughter named Lily. I coach the dance team. I'm obsessed with cats, and I'm scared of lice.
My name is D. Christopher. I'm named after my grandfather. My wife of 21 years is a doctor. She teaches at Clover. I've got 3 kids, Hannah, Kate, Meredith, and Kate. What I do?
If you want your chance at 7 Seconds, make sure you tweet us with the hashtag each week.
We'll reveal this week's hashtag at the end of the show.
It's been a quiet week for all of our Jacket athletes because we're right in between seasons, and most of the teams are just getting ready to start up and compete.
Josh is here with an update on all things sports.
Hey, Fort Mill, I'm Josh, and in the spirit of Thanksgiving, I'm thankful for everybody who's helped me out with sports this year, especially one person in particular.
Me!
That's right, and it's time for the Buzz Sports with Enthusiasm.
Part 2.
What are you thankful for, David?
Cheerleaders.
Speaking of cheerleaders, they got 7th place in the state championship. What are you looking at?
Cheerleaders. Huh.
It was 21-7. I think you did pretty good. The FF7 need to improve. Mom! Oh, God.
Yeah, the score wasn't 21-7. I have no clue what he was talking about. I honestly don't even think he scored. But the boys and girls basketball teams both play on the 5th against Forest View. Well, the football team lost last week, and I just want to say that I'm extremely disappointed in everyone that didn't go to the game because it was too cold. Like, you might as well go to NAFA with the spirit like that.
Yeah, I didn't go.
You know, what the heck? You know, that's all for sports this week.
Can I go home now?
Thanks, Josh.
We wish the best of luck to our winter athletes on their upcoming season.
We do. We had a really successful hunger drive this year. We collected 15,020 pounds of cans, averaging to about 8 pounds per student.
And most of these cans go to the Fort Mill Food Pantry, where they help local people in need.
Alexa was able to see just how much these cans make a difference.
Really quick, so that's what With millions of people going hungry this holiday season, one local organization is doing their best to provide Fort Mill families with all of their basic needs. Jean Cassidy, the chair of this food pantry, educates us on the importance of donations.
Donations are very important because the vast majority of the food that we give out is food that was directly donated to us. We purchase items that we are low on or that we don't get enough of.
The pantry is in need of canned foods such as meat and fruit, but non-perishable foods as well as baby and personal care items are always accepted.
It feels good to volunteer here. You leave here feeling good. You know you've helped people that are in need in this community.
Volunteering is a huge part of this food pantry, but also the canned food drive that we do at our very own Fort Mill High School.
This food drive is fantastic because it brings in so much food. That's a big amount of food to come in a food drive.
The food pantry is very thankful for our food drive. However, it wouldn't be possible without our many helping hands.
Without the students especially, this wouldn't have happened. Student Council works really hard, but we can't bring in 15,000 pounds by ourselves. So without the faculty and the staff and the students all working and coming together, this would not have been near as successful as it was this year.
Thank you to everyone who participated in this food drive. I'm Alexa, reporting for The Buzz.
Thanks, Alexa. You know, donating to the food pantry is a great way to make a noticeable difference this holiday season.
It sure is, and Thanksgiving is right around the corner, and you know what that means.
Turkey time!
That's right, and Bada got a chance to meet some turkeys at Dubhar Farms. Here she is with more.
Most of us know about the traditional Thanksgiving turkey, but do you guys know what it takes to raise one? I'm here at the Dubhar's farm in Monroe, North Carolina to find out.
Dubhar Farm has a big variety of different animals. I got to meet so many of them, but the one type of farm animal I was most excited to see were the Thanksgiving turkeys. Did you know that there are 5 types of wild turkeys in the United States? The owner of this farm has 2 of these breeds.
We started with the standard bronze, and that means it's most like a wild bronze turkey. The Royal Palm is another heritage breed. That's the white bird with the black markings. And they're different from a commercial bird because they don't have as much meat on them as the commercial bird. But they're much more flavorful when you have them for dinner. Turkeys eat seeds, they like bugs, and they love pecans.
Have you ever wondered how turkeys differ from other poultry?
I guess they're similar to chickens. Chickens are more aggressive, I think. Turkeys are just a little bit dumber.
Meeting these creatures was a very exciting experience. I'm so glad that these turkeys won't be the ones on my plate during Thanksgiving. I'm Vata, reporting for The Buzz.
There's so much about turkeys I didn't know.
There sure is. And this season is all about being thankful and giving back.
Students will do just that when they participate in this year's blood drive held right here at the school.
Someone needs blood about every 2 seconds. That's around 41,000 donations needed daily.
Here's Nicole on everything you need to know about the blood drive.
The giving season's already here, Fort Mill, and that means we started giving thanks and might not even blood. On November 25th, the Fort Mill Red Cross Club is holding their annual blood drive here in the auxiliary gym. In just 1 hour, your body is able to give up to 1 pint of blood and save up to 3 lives. Giving blood not only reduces the risk of heart disease as well as cancer, but also helps burn calories. Only 37% of the U.S. population is able to give blood due to possible restrictions.
Other than bringing picture identification, Coach Merritt gives us details on preparation for making a difference.
Well, you want to make sure that you eat a good breakfast the morning of. Make sure that you're getting iron-rich food. And make sure you're good and hydrated. Try and avoid caffeine and that sort of thing. Well, one of the things they make folks do after they give blood is sit at a table, eat while they're sitting at that table to make sure that they don't feel lightheaded or dizzy. And then make sure you have a normal lunch.
I decided to give blood because I want to help those in need. I would tell my friends that they're saving someone else's life by doing something so little.
If you missed the deadline or may not be 17 yet, you can always schedule your own appointment at redcrossblood.org. With just some basic information, you can give the liquid of life. Reporting for The Buzz, I'm Nicole. Have a great Thanksgiving, Fort Mill.
Thanks, Nicole. Here's a couple of weekly announcements.
Girls, if you want to participate in pageant, there's an interest meeting November 24th in the Media Center after school. Cross-country members are reminded to turn in their uniforms and a bag with your name on it to Mr. Pearson. The Swarm meets Tuesdays in C-102. And for those of you who don't know what the Swarm is, here's a little more on who they are and what they do.
A Swarm is just kind of like a student-run organization to just kind of get people to show up to spring and winter games instead of the fall, like instead of just football, just to get them to come out to JV and varsity sports. To get people excited for the games, we have giveaways like Fan of the Games. We get a free t-shirt and free meals. We do dodgeball tournaments and half-court shot competitions. You know, you can get famous during the game.
Thanksgiving means family, pumpkin pie, turkey, and a lot of different special traditions.
And a lot of our families like to incorporate many different traditions into our Thanksgiving season.
Nunu found a couple ways everyone likes to celebrate.
100 years ago, Thanksgiving Day would have been spent cooking dinner and spending time with families and friends. After dinner, most families would listen to some of the special Thanksgiving radio broadcasts, like the presidential Thanksgiving address. But over the years, there's been many changes in the original Thanksgiving Day. In 1924, Macy's decided to put on a parade as a Christmas celebration for their employees. Many of the spectators were surprised to see all the exotic ideas that were displayed as they walked along the streets of New York City. The following year, Macy's decided to make it a Thanksgiving parade instead, and the giant floats that we have come to know today soon arrived 3 years later. Let's not forget the Thanksgiving football games. The first ever Thanksgiving game was between the Detroit Lions and the Chicago Bears. They set up the tradition of playing and watching football on Thanksgiving. These are some of the well-known traditions, but what are some of your traditions?
My family and I, we all sit at dinner and have our Thanksgiving meal, and then afterwards we all decorate for Christmas.
I eat turkey.
On Thanksgiving, my grandmother makes microwavable pizzas.
Every Thanksgiving, me and my family always meet up at Clemson University the weekend before the Carolina game.
And my 5,000 brothers and I have tacos.
Every Thanksgiving, I break apart the wishbone.
Hoping you have a wonderful Thanksgiving. I'm Nunu, reporting for The Buzz.
It's cool to see how many different ways we celebrate the same holiday.
It sure is. What are you thankful for, Chad?
I'm thankful for my family. What are you thankful for?
Definitely for my family and all my friends here at Fort Mill. Abby went around the school to find out what we're all thankful for this Thanksgiving season.
Hey, Fort Mill. With Thanksgiving break right around the corner, I went around the school and asked you guys what you're thankful for.
I am thankful for my wife and my three youngins. I am thankful for a school.
I'm thankful for my daughter, Amanda.
I am thankful for John Romanski's facial hair.
And administrators that make my job so easy.
I am thankful for air conditioning in the gym as we do the Pacer test.
I'm thankful for my family and my friends.
I'm thankful for the weekends.
I'm thankful for my family and my friends.
I'm thankful for college actually wanting me.
I'm thankful for my family and Taco Bell.
I'm thankful for my AP Bio students and all the hard work they put into making this dance amazing.
The thing that I'm most thankful for is my wife and kids.
I'm just blessed and thankful all together.
I'm thankful for warm winter nights I can spend with my boy Josh Tanzi.
I'm thankful for my mom.
I'm thankful for the football team making it to the playoffs.
I'm thankful for Allie Abbott.
I'm thankful for Ms. Dowd.
I'm thankful for fuzzy socks.
I'm thankful for moose and hairspray.
I'm thankful for my dog.
I am thankful for the C-100 hall and especially for Ms. Slater for giving me a home during first block.
I'm thankful for my loving God and my awesome teachers this year.
I'm thankful for my beautiful family, my amazing wife, my amazing daughter, the fact that I get to come here and hang out with you guys all day.
I'm thankful this Thanksgiving for my family.
I'm thankful for my family, my health, my strength.
I'm thankful for wonderful friends and family and the availability and access to a great education here at Fort Mill.
Thanks, Abby.
It's so sweet to be able to see all the four-year-olds and what they're grateful for.
If you want to be featured on our next show, make sure you use the hashtag BuzzedOnTurkey.
That wraps it up for this week. I'm Stephanie.
And I'm Chad.
Have a great Thanksgiving break, Fort Mill.
You know, donating to the food pantry is a great way to... Yeah.
Huge deal, as it provides...
Aw, you're doing so good.
I know, I am.
Go!
So donating to the food pantry is a great way to make a commitment.
Is in full swing. Oh my gosh. I can... Alright. Come on.
Ready?
The food here is vital to many. The food here is vital to many.
There's so much about turkeys I didn't know.
You're right. I forgot my line.
It's
all right. How do you clap?
John, my face is gonna freeze.
Really? I'm not crying.
No, no.
I'm legitly about to like shed tears.
Twice.
Let's go.
All right. It's still recording, so whenever you're ready. Turkey time.